land resources. While I explain this topic, you should have your textbook with you and you have to go through that textbook, page number 5. Land resources. We use the land for various purposes. Not only we, even the wildlife, the animals, plants, everyone use the land resources. There are various relief features for land. Whenever we study about our country, India, the land features, the relief features of land in our country is like this: mountains, plateaus and the plains. Mountains covers 30% of our country, plains covers 43% of our country and plateaus 27%. What the mountains gives to our country? They provide us the rivers. Rivers are originating from the mountains and they come into the plains. While they come from the mountains, they bring the sediments or the fertile soil and they deposit in the down area wherever the plains forms. Next one, plateaus. Plateaus are the good source of minerals and the fossil fuels. Plains are the fertile land, so good amount of agriculture and good amount of population lives over there. Mountains, they are having picturesque locations. That is why Mount Abu, many foreigners are coming. Himalayan mountains, many people are coming to see the Himalayan mountains because of these reasons. So all these features, relief features of land, got its own importance for our country. Now we are going to study about land utilization. The land resources are used for various purposes. In that, the first one is forest. All the countries, a particular area should be used for forest, should be made for forest region. For the ecological balance of that country, it is to be there. Second one, land not available for cultivation. In that, two categories are there: barren and waste land. Barren means dry land and the waste land. While you go to Mount of Udaipur and while you go to Sirohi, you will be able to see kilometers distance area with the dry land and the waste land, the land which is not used for any cultivation. Next one, land put to non-agricultural uses. That means the roads, buildings, railway lines, wherever these roads are, the railway tracks are, the buildings are there, we will not be able to use that area for any cultivation. So that is coming under land put into non-agricultural uses. Third category is other uncultivated land. In that, three categories are the permanent pastures and grazing land. Wherever the cattle are grazing, wherever the pasturing land are, the permanent pasturing lands are, that area we are not able to do any cultivation. Miscellaneous tree growth grows. On the roadside, you will be able to see various mango trees and other trees, neem trees and all, which we are not able to use any. That area we are not able to use any cultivation at all. Third one, controlled wasteland left uncultivated for more than 5 agricultural years. Some lands are the which is under disputes or cases are going on, and that land area we are not using for any cultivational purposes. So that type of areas are called as controlled wasteland left uncultivated for more than 5 agricultural years. Fourth category, fallow land. What do you mean by fallow? We give rest to the land. If you are using the land continuously, the soil will lose its fertility. So we have to give rest to the land. That area is called as fallow land. In that also, two categories are the current fallow left without cultivation for more than 1 agricultural year. For 1 or less than 1 agricultural year. We are not doing cultivation in a particular land area because the soil loses its fertility. So we cannot do that cultivation again. So that area is called as current fallow. Next one, other than current fallow, left uncultivated for the past 1 to 5 agricultural years. We are not doing any cultivation for the last 5 years. So these two are coming under fallow land. 1 year below or 1 to 5 years. Last one is net sown area where the cultivation is going on. Area sown more than once in an agricultural year plus net sown area is called as gross cropped area. Wherever we are doing cultivation presently, that area is called as net sown area. So the land can be used into various purposes like this. Forest, land not available for cultivation in that wasteland and roads are not coming. Next one, other uncultivated land, permanent pastures, miscellaneous trees, crops, grows left uncultivated for more than 5 years. Next one, fallow, given rest to the land 1 year below or 1 to 5 years. Last one, wherever we are doing cultivation presently. Okay, thank you.